Hey everybody, it's Nick from Coleman's Music, and today I am here with an exciting comparison video between the Fender 68 Custom VibroChamp and the Vox AC10 C1. So the reason we thought this video might be interesting is because although these two amps do sound quite different, they do service a similar need. They're both small package valve amps, little combos, really easy to transport around, really easy to stick a microphone in front of and record with without upsetting anyone. They sound great, and they're really useful tools to have. So I'm just going to go through some of the specs of both of these amps and try and help you guys decide which one might suit you better. Obviously the tone comparison is going to be the main thing there, but they do have a couple of little differences that might make you lean towards one rather than the other. So starting off with the Vox AC10, this is a 10 watt valve amp. It features two 12AX7 preamp tubes and two EL84 power amp tubes. It has gain control, bass and treble. It has a digital reverb built in. Both reverbs in these amps are digital, not spring. This one is, it doesn't actually say what flavor of reverb it is, but it's just a nice sounding reverb. The other thing that this amp does have is a master volume, which can be super handy if you're recording at home, because you can drive that preamp super hard and get the amp to break up, but you can control the overall volume of the amp so that it's not screaming away in your apartment. The AC10 features a 10-inch 16-ohm Celestion VX10 speaker, which is a nice 10-inch speaker. It's got a fair bit of bottom end to it that hopefully this video will demonstrate, but certainly in the room it sounds nice and full. On the back here, it has an external speaker out, which is also a 16-ohm output. So if you showed up to a gig with this little amp and it wasn't cutting the mustard, and perhaps there was a Marshall, you know, 1960s A cab as backline that the venue had there, you could pop this on top, plug it in, and sound absolutely monstrous. Both of these amps are small package amps, so they are quite light, but the Vox is slightly heavier. This is 12.3 kilograms. So just factor that in, that's what you're gonna be carrying to your car. All right, so moving on to the Fender. The Fender is 5 watts and it features two 12AX7 preamp tubes and one 6V6 power amp tube. Although it is half the wattage, it's probably not half the volume. They both do get quite loud. Obviously they're breaking up at that point, but you could easily compete with the drummer in a practice scenario. I don't know about in a live setting, but then it would be mic'd up anyway, so yeah. The Fender VibroChamp also features a 10-inch speaker, which is different to the original VibroChamps, which were 8-inch speakers. This one features a Celestion 1030. It's a 3.2 ohm speaker, and you can unplug it from the back and you can plug it into other cabs. It's 3.2 ohms minimum, so you can run other cabs with it, and it does sound really cool when you do that too. As I said before, the Fender does feature a digital reverb as well. The reverb in this is a hall reverb. It's just a really useful, kind of sweet sounding reverb. In addition to that, it also has a tremolo, you got a speed control here, and an intensity, so it's a really, really nice vintage sounding tube tremolo. The effects in this amp are also foot switchable, so that makes it really, really useful for live performance, obviously. And yes, as I said before, this doesn't have a master volume, but you can get some really nice cleans out of it when it's quiet. And then when you crank it up, it has this great driving classic sound, think Rolling Stones. As I mentioned before, the Fender is slightly lighter. It's 9.25 kilograms. So maybe that could be something that you're factoring in. Are you the kind of player who's traveling a lot with this amplifier? Maybe the Fender is the one to pick for that reason. All right, so I'm gonna have a play through both of them now and just demonstrate some of the sounds that these guys are capable of. So here you go, have a listen.
Thank you. We'll be right back.